praise you, the Lord, and we say praise the Lord to everyone and greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We thank the Lord for allowing us to be here this afternoon. We thank the Lord for how the Lord has kept us over the dangerous highways, allowing us to be here to worship, praise, and to honor our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ once more and again. To have this a privilege and this an opportunity to do so. We thank God for the leaders here. We thank God for Elder Brendels and all of the others, Brother Price and all of the others in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank God for the absence of love, Elder Brian and all of the elders, all of the deacons, all of the brothers and all of the mothers and sisters, each and every one of you. We're glad for all of you to be here present before God. Amen. We thank God for this, a chance and a great opportunity that he has allowed us to be able to have breath, have life, to be able to give him praises, for he is worthy. But the scripture says, let everything that has breath, amen, praise the Lord. Amen. Didn't he say so? Amen. Somebody say, well, I ain't got the Holy Ghost, I ain't been baptized, but you know you got something God gave you.
Amen.
You got something God gave you. So he said that everything that have it, praise him. Is that all right? Everything that have breath, praise the Lord. Is that right? One scripture said, praise him with a dance. And one scripture say, praise him with the high sound of his. Then he say something. Yeah. Amen. Make some noise, you understand. Yeah. One scripture say, let us make a joyful noise unto the Lord. He said, all ye land. Then he say something. Serve the Lord with what? Gladness. Come before him. Present with saints. But it's a good thing. It's a good thing to give God praise. Amen. So I say, oh, no, I'm not a member of that church. Well, listen, it doesn't matter if you're a member of this church. You are a member of the human family. Aren't you? So it doesn't matter. Somebody says, well, I'm too young to praise the Lord. You are not too young to die. Is that all right? Amen. You're not too young for that. So when you can, give God thanks, give him praise. Yeah. You can praise him and thank him that you got parents that love you, children.
That's right. That's
parents that want to take care of you, want you to do the right thing.
Yeah.
Want you to be in the service, want you to hear things that is essential for life.
Yes,
is that right? So that you can be a people that God is calling for. I know how it is sometimes, you know. Want to come and you don't want to be in no church and stay in church too long and do all these kind of things. Is that right? But when you're out there partying,
it could be
3 o'clock in the morning. You want the DJ to play one more song?
Just
play one more. I stand the cue. Amen. So you can get your slow drag in a good long 10 minutes.
Yeah.
But then to get here, it's too long. Is that all right? But learn to give God praise. Learn to thank you. Thank you for your parents. Thank you for your aunt, your grandma, whoever it may be. That God has blessed you. I have blessed in your life. Thank God for them. You could be hungry. Ain't too many people that are hungry. Because if you are, I heard the city had some soul waters and stuff in chicken. So you can sure get your meal before you leave up there. So you ain't gonna leave me hungry. But always remember to do that. I thank God for my companion. Thank God, that's my son, Gwen. That's my wife. I need number one to stay. Number one. Number two. Three is not here. Four is not here. Five.
My God.
Number six. I want number seven. He's not in, but number eight.
Might be in the back.
Number nine. Well, the oldest boy and the youngest son is here. Well, our other son, the middle boy, number
eight.
He's not here. But he'll be soon getting married. But look, this is my wife of over 40 years.
Thank God.
Thank God.
Thank God for my son-in-law that married my fifth daughter. Thank God for my other son-in-law that married my first daughter. Thank God for my son-in-law that married my second daughter. And my son-in-law that married my third daughter. Amen. Yeah. There's still some availability. But I thank God. Amen. Y'all tell any man whatever you. And then I just want to say something real brief. This is my other son right here. Stand up, Graham. That's my grandson.
All right.
Where my other grandson at? Where are my granddaughters? Y'all stand up, dearest. These are my granddaughters. I'm glad they pressed out to be here.
Yeah.
Amen. I can't get up early, but I'm glad that they're here. I thank God for how the Lord has blessed us, my wife and I, to be able to raise our children, striving to raise them in the right way, in the way of holiness. Bring them up in the way that they should go.
Amen.
You know, and that's what we have strived to do for the years that we have had our children. And I thank God for my lovely wife,
thank
in the name
God.
Of Jesus Christ. And thank God she don't have to worry about me. And I don't have to worry about her.
Right.
I don't have to worry about her. And can't no woman point their finger at me. You can't get in the church and clean your throat on me. You can't clean your throat on me. Is that all right? You better speak now, forever hold your peace. Amen. Why? Because God made a change.
Yeah.
I heard your sister singing a song, how God should change us. You know?
Yeah.
That's what God has to do with young people. Old people. We have to change our life.
Yeah.
That's why repenting is so important.
Amen.
That's why the scripture says repent. What you mean? Turn away. You know, stop doing certain things. It's certain things you got to stop doing when it comes to Christ. Because God wants us to be new creatures in Him. There's a lot of things. I know you got friends. I know how it is. You know, I know how the peer pressure is with the young people. You got so many things, but keep a good, solid, straight mind with them.
Yeah.
Don't let the enemy try to bring nothing in your mind to do
that's
nothing
right.
evil to yourself, to your peers, or no one. Is that right? When things try to come, you know it's a name that's above every name.
Yeah.
A name that has all power.
Yeah.
And you're being taught who to call on.
Yeah.
Is that right?
Yeah.
He said, call Sammy on the cell. And he said, call Sammy on the cell. Jill, call on G.
Yeah.
You know, come a time you got to put the cell down.
Yeah.
Amen. You got to put the cell down and go in the closet and call on Jesus when things begin to press you. But I understand, as being young people, there's a lot of things that's pressing you all that didn't press us.
That's right.
But there is help always in Jesus.
Yes, it is.
There, right? There's always help in Jesus. There's always, if you're in this atmosphere right here now, there's always somebody that you can go to and talk to. And let them know, you know, I'm having problems.
Amen.
And you pray and pray with me. Pray for me. Is that right?
Amen.
It's good to have that kind of
Amen.
People
Amen.
Around you. So we're glad for you. And we say to the young, continue in the Lord, strive to do what the Lord would have you do. Because God loves you too.
Amen.
Amen. This right here is not saying this is an old people's religion.
All right.
The scripture says the promise is unto you and to your children. Didn't he say so?
Yes.
All that's afar off.
Yeah.
Even as many as the Lord our God shall call. And with many other words,
yes,
he testified and said, save yourself.
Save yourself.
I'm just under one generation. Amen. Maybe your friend may not want to come, but if God press on your heart to repent, stop doing things, and to be baptized in the water in the name of Jesus Christ, you need to do it.
Yeah.
Is that right? Because he said, remember now that created in the days of thy youth.
Right.
Didn't he say so?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Even days don't draw nigh, because there's going to come a time where you ain't going to be able to do what you're doing now.
That's right.
Is that right? Oh, yeah, there's come a time you may be strong, you may be running, you may be pretty, you may be handsome, but all that's going to end. Is that right?
Yeah.
Just like our life going in. The scripture says it's appointed a man wants to die. After that, judgment.
Yes.
So we all stand in judgment.
Yes.
Is that all right?
Yes.
Amen. So we thank God. I thank God about a month or so ago, as my daughter had testified, something. I was a very ill man. I didn't realize how ill I was, but I thank God that he made it possible for me that I didn't lose my life.
Thank God.
I was a bus driver for about 29 years. And I was at the wheel. I was at my last run of the day. And I happened to cross the street, this street called Capitol Circle. I don't remember when I crossed it. And the next thing I knew, when I came to, here I am trying to dodge poles and trying to dodge trees. And the bus, I just went slap out.
Oh, Jesus.
I just like went O-U-T. 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 I was like, gone. And then when I did come to, here I am, you know, trying to do what I could do. But I thank God that he took care of me.
Yeah.
I didn't have any passengers on the bus. I weren't drunk. I weren't high. But my body was shutting down to the point I was not getting oxygen to my brain. I was losing oxygen. I didn't realize that. I knew I was feeling bad. You know, I was feeling good. And then they had to call to eat. They wanted to say, Daddy, you better go. You better go. Yeah, I said, I don't feel like going. I don't want to. Is that all right? We're going to call the EMS over. And then they came in and they surrounded the bed out of the body. So eventually I just made up my mind to go ahead and go.
Is that right?
Then after I did that, I ended up staying in the hospital for about a week or so.
Yeah.
Is that right? Because I had a bad case of bronchitis and I had pneumonia and wasn't getting oxygen, all this stuff that was going on. But I thank God. That's why I tell anybody. Young people who never hear, give God praise.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, don't come into church and sit down on
them.
Testify, talk about it.
Yeah.
Say something.
Yeah. Yes, Lord.
They're right. Just sit down. No, you don't just sit down. They come in and sit down and just say, well, you ain't going to say nothing. You know what? Those of you that don't even have the Holy Ghost, don't you know you can get up and say, well, I don't have the Holy Ghost, but I thank God that I'm alive. I mean, you know, a long time ago, my dad used to carry us around the older people's houses. We was little boys, you know, my brother and I. And, you know, we'd go around to the older people's houses. And, you know, they don't eat cookies in another way like we do. They go and eat them up. You know, young people, they eat them up. But then they want to do something so good for you. So what they'll do, they'll say, come in, you want a little something? And they're going to give you a cookie with cream inside, right? And though when you bite into it, you're waiting for the crunch.
Mm-hmm.
But you just get the salt. But regardless of how soft it was or how soft it is, the parents always told you to say something.
Yeah.
Regardless of how it looks, the parents see you squinting up and you just ain't feeling right about it, but they tell you to say thank you. They say, what you folks will say, boy?
Thank you.
It ain't really what I want. It ain't tasting like I want to taste. But I got to say thank you. Life is not all the time sweet like we want it. But he is doing things for us.
Yeah.
He's giving us life. We're not starving.
Yeah.
We have a roof over our head.
Yeah.
We have expensive clothes that we wear sometimes. All these different things, you know. We can tell him thank you.
Yeah.
And then if you don't get that pair of 200 calling her daddy or grandma. You might be with grandma.
Right.
And grandma want to do for you.
Amen.
But she just can't get that $200. She can get that $25 or $30.
Amen.
But one thing about you, you're
not barefoot. That's right.
And all you need to say is,
thank you.
Because when we give God thanks, he'll do more for you. You know, when you ever done something to somebody, and you did it for them, and then you look around and say, you know what? They didn't even say thank you. You know, I drive bus sometimes, and sometimes I'm running a tight schedule, and sometimes I see somebody come across, and sometimes I wait, I'm trying to wait, because I knew these passengers trying to catch the other bus, and they'll get right up on the bus, pay the money, won't see nothing.
Talk, preacher.
I look in the mirror, I say, good as this saying, thank you. Yeah. Don't that make you feel good?
Yeah.
You know, sometimes you do things, how much I owe you? All you got to do is just say, I thank you.
Yeah.
So all we have to do is tell the Lord, thank you. And you know, when we can do that, then we can receive more. Because that let us know and let the Lord know, or either those know, that you appreciate.
Yes.
Is that all right?
Amen.
That's why I appreciate life.
Yeah.
You know, I heard my daughter talking. Sometimes my kids look on. I mean, I didn't know I was in that bad shape, man. Now, you know, he told me.
Hallelujah.
He was in the hospital.
Hallelujah.
I had these things upon me, but I still laid at night. I woke up and I downed the knee.
Jesus.
I got to move. I just crawl out of bed.
Yes, yes.
But I just look to the Lord.
Yes.
See, I want to continue to give him thanks.
Yes.
Regardless of the circumstances.
Yes.
Regardless of how things look.
Yes.
But I'm too sick to get a break. I want to show humbleness.
Yes, sir.
I want to show humility to the Lord.
Because
I want deliverance.
Yes.
Don't you want deliverance?
Yes.
She fell in the street and the angels round about. Yeah. That's why we serve the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Is that right?
Amen.
Amen. Let's go to Revelation, I believe it is, where it talks about, I think it's the 5th or 11th chapter of Revelation, where it talks about those that are around the throne worshiping and saying, is that right? Glory. Is that right? 5th chapter of Revelation.
Verse 11.
Let's hear what verse 11 said. I thought about it when Mother was talking about the angels. You know,
yes.
It's a blessing when
yes.
you, God,
yes.
have angels
yes.
and camp round about.
Thank you.
Is that right?
Yes.
Because let me tell all of us something. If God didn't have angels and protection all around us,
uh-huh.
we would leave him today and all of us would die.
Amen.
I mean, we would. You know why? Because the enemy, the devil, Lucifer, he don't want nobody to go back with the Lord. He wants everybody to go back with him. So he's the enemy of our soul.
That's right.
So whatever he could do, if he could, you know what happened, right? With Job. He talked to the Lord about Job, didn't he? Amen. He talked to the Lord about Job, and Job was there, and Job went through a whole lot.
That's right.
But he said, your soul, you can't have a soul.
No.
I ain't going to let you have his soul.
Yeah.
Is that right? He lost a lot of things. And sometimes in life, we feel as though that we are not where we should be and doing what we should do and having what we should do have. And sometimes our mind, that's why the scripture says, with the mind we serve the Lord.
Yes.
We got to keep a good spiritual mind. Young people, keep a good mind. You got a mind that want to serve the Lord, you go ahead and strive to serve the Lord.
Right.
Is that right? You do what's right. Amen. Don't let the things out in the world and all kind of things that regulate your mind. Because the scripture says, with the mind we serve Christ. Is that right? So we got to have that good mind. Don't let anything just get in your mind and you think about all kind of things, doing all kind of things. But do that which is right. Because the enemy of our soul, he is out there. He is lurking because the scripture says he's as a roaring lion walking about, seeking whom he may devour. The enemy, the devil, that spirit don't care nothing about none of us.
No, sir.
Christ died for us. God sent him. And that's who loves you. Is that right? He loves you. Don't you do so. All right, what it says.
Revelations 5 and started verse 9.
Then we may go over to Job. Go ahead.
And they sung a new song.
Well, they sung a new song.
Saying?
Saying what?
Thou art worthy to take the book.
Amen. These words, Jesus Christ, the one that God sent. Mm-hmm. The one that died for us.
Yeah.
The one that shed his blood.
That's
you're worthy to take the book.
And to open the seals.
Open the seals thereof.
But thou was slain.
You were slain. Wasn't he slain?
Yes, sir.
He was slain.
And has redeemed us to God by the by thy blood.
Wait a minute. Glory to God.
Yes. Watch yourself.
Is that all right?
Yes.
Watch yourself.
He was slain.
Yes.
And has redeemed us because we had lost our state of holiness in the Garden of Eden.
Yes.
When Adam and Eve was out there, we lost our state of holiness.
Yes.
Amen. But God so loved the world.
Yes.
Didn't he do something?
Yes.
That he sent, gave his only begotten son.
Yes.
That whosoever believes in him. That's why we have to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
That's why we have to seek God for the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
I hear God say, if the Spirit that was in Christ Jesus, that raised him from the dead, dwell in you, he shall quicken your mortal body by his Spirit. That's why everybody needs God's Spirit. Young and old, rich or poor, you need the Spirit of God. In this world that we're living in, we need it. There's so much wickedness and so many things that's going on. Our minds are being just, it's all kind of things. If it ain't on, hold yourself, keep yourself together. It's a whole lot of lust out there. Women walk around hand buck naked. Men walk around with their pants all down by the drawers and all kinds of things. And sometimes you got women and young girls that like that kind of stuff. What kind of man is that? Walk around with his pants down. How you gonna keep you? How you gonna keep working and pull up your pants more than you do when you work? And then our children look on and then they wanna pick up that spirit. Is that right?
Amen.
That's why he said, creating then he said, create in me.
Yes.
Didn't say so.
Yes.
Heart. And renew a right spirit within me. We need the right spirit within us in this evil and sinful world that we're in. Young people, you need to ask God, Lord, give me the right spirit. Help me to do what's right. Help me to strive. Don't let me fall under the lust. And don't let me fall under these things that people are doing. Don't let you fall under drugs. Don't let you fall under pedophiles.
Amen.
Don't let you fall under these all kind of things. Young girls, you got to be careful.
Right.
You're a young man, you got to be wild. Because you got all this stuff out there. And it's lurking, it's trying to get you. But we have one, glory to God, that has died for us. That has shed blood. That we may be redeemed by his blood. And have not been the shadow of the fact almighty of his blood. It will be no remission.
Yes,
but I thank God through Jesus Christ. Football player. I could
Help us, Lord, help us.
Yes, sir. Tell that boy. Ain't all the time beating his side. Stand up, Jonathan. That's my oldest son. I was old, I was Zaire. I was shaking up too.
That's all right.
All right, man.
I was shaking up. You look at see, you always been that way. I used to run a 40 in 4.5, 4.6. I used to run. I used to run the pill.
The anchor,
the pill.
Anchor.
I used to run football.
Yes, sir.
Run track. But one day.
That's all right.
Glory to God.
Yes. Thank you, God.
One day God chasing our soul.
Yes, sir.
And my mind.
He did.
I heard the word being preached. And I need to turn away from that old sinful world.
Yes.
And I went down in water in the name of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Is that right? After which I received the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
You can't kill me, young man. Young woman, God won't give you the Holy Ghost.
That's right.
Is that right?
That's
he said, repent.
Yes, sir.
And God will bless you with the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
But do you want it?
He did. Yes,
do you want it?
Yes,
that's the point. Do you want it?
Yes,
can you, do you want the Holy Ghost?
That's it, right there.
I don't want it, but do you want to die?
Yeah.
Well, you need something to die with.
Yeah.
You need something that's going to help you.
Yeah.
That the Lord can look on and say, he tried.
Yes,
and have mercy.
Yeah.
So don't say God can't. God done kept me ever since I was 18 going on 19.
Wow.
This month, the 11th of April, God blessed me with the Holy Ghost. I was still in high school, April 11th, 1975.
Wow.
The next day was my birthday.
Uh-huh.
April 12th, my birthday will be in. I'll be 62.
Wow.
God has been keeping me ever since then.
Yes.
Then it wasn't long after he blessed me with a nice wife.
Right.
I was 22 years old. At 21, she was 19. And we've been married ever since.
That's all right.
Now you see what you know. Is that all right? God has kept
me.
Yeah. I feared the Lord.
Yeah.
I didn't want to do some of anything.
Yeah.
When God brought me out, he brought me out.
That's right.
I wasn't sleeping around.
That's right.
See, you got a lot of people sleeping around.
Yes,
they are. And that's the problem even in the church today.
Yes.
See, some people turn away from the church because you got too many preachers sleeping.
That's right.
I ain't talking about that song, but I think it was Johnny Taylor saying, slip away. Y'all remember that note?
We ain't talking about that.
We ain't talking about slipping away. We ain't talking about doing that. Talking about serving the Lord.
Yes,
young people, whenever God bless you, stay with the Lord.
Amen.
Young man, you get married, stay with God.
That's right.
Be honest with your wife. Love your wife.
Yeah.
Woman, love your husband.
Yeah.
Right. He may not be bringing everything in, but encourage him. Rub his head.
That's right.
Hands some chicken and tell him, honey, you're doing a good job.
Teach well.
Because you know what that'll do? That'll encourage him.
Yeah.
I want to get to know. Take some more. Encourage a man in a way you don't even know how.
Because
God gave him you to be a helpmate.
Yes.
So encourage that man.
Yes.
He's going to
walk
in. Is that right?
Yes,
things look rough because he be holding his head down. See, you'll be all right.
That's right.
As long as he know that his other half is all right, he'll try.
That's right.
Be all right now. That make a big difference. That make a big difference.
Yes,
a woman can encourage a man in a way she don't even know how.
Yes.
Then that same woman can bring him to his demise. Amen. So man, if you get a good one, thank God. Woman that got a good husband that loves you and want to try to take care if he ain't working his and doing all what you think he can do. Maybe things get tight sometimes. I can't even start talking about how things got tight with me and my wife. Glory to God. Sometimes you think of things that you come through. They bring tears to your eyes. Bring tears to your eyes.
Yes,
you want to see what God did for you.
Yes, Lord.
Yes. Parents can tell the children. I remember when. Wife having babies. What happened? The heater went out.
Come on, preacher.
the furnace when it was cold. What I had to do, I had to go get an electric. He didn't want to get that because it gonna cost too much.
Yeah.
But I had to get it.
Yes.
Is that all right?
Yes. That's all right.
She wasn't grumbling to her. Well, when we gonna get heat? She just was humble and said, it'll be all right.
That's right. You blessed. You blessed.
We had young men breastfeeding me, young. To me, young. That's why I thank God for my in-law, my grand. My wife's mother and stuff, how she took one of the old, we had the youngest one. Is that right?
Amen.
But I thank God that God was able to keep us. I'm trying to tell you that whatever you may be going through or think you're going through, God is able to keep us. Yes. You got to do that day to day. David said, I will look
to the heathen.
I will look to the heathen. From what? Let's come. Is that right?
Yes,
even as being holy people, having the love of God that God wants to have, we got to go through things. Things come up in the church, but we still got to go through. I ain't going to quit just like on your job. Things come up on your job, but you don't quit your job. I got to hang in here.
Hold on.
I'm going to have to go to work when I ain't want to go. I'm going to have to go to work in the rain.
On the earth.
We shall reign on the earth.
And I beheld, and I heard the voice of many angels round about
the throne. I heard the voice of many angels.
Yes.
Round about the throne.
And the beasts and elders.
Beasts and the elders.
And the number of them was 10,000.
And the number of them. But they was around the throne. You got to understand. Who's on the throne? Christ is on the throne.
Yes, yes. They were sitting on the throne.
Is that right?
Yes.
Amen. But I seen something round the throne. He had a vision that the Lord let John behold.
Yeah.
Is that right?
Yes.
Let's see what happened.
Yes.
And I beheld and heard the voice of many angels. The
voice of many angels.
Round about the throne.
Round about the throne.
And the beast and the elders.
Uh-huh.
And the number of them was 10,000 times 10,000.
Hold.
Glory to God. What a time. What a time.
Huh?
Oh,
they round the throne.
Amen.
Oh,
all around the throne.
Yeah.
You not know when we come together, we're around the throne.
Yeah.
The eyes of the Lord is in every place.
Yeah.
We not be literally around, but we the earth is in
yeah.
Yes.
Is that right?
Yes.
So we're down here.
Yes.
Whenever you come to a king, most people come, they come out.
Yeah.
Is that right? Yeah. I heard God say through the word that every knee shall bow.
Come on.
Yes. Yes. So.
Yes.
Every tongue shall that she is Lord to the glory of God.
Yes,
you've got to give him praise.
Yes,
you've got to give him glory.
Yes,
so he heard the angel say, what did he say, my brother?
The number there was 10,000 times 10,000.
Hold it for 1 minute. 10,000 times 10,000.
Yes.
That's a lot.
That's a lot.
That's 100 million.
Don't you know it? Don't you know
all right.
it?
10,000 times. Is that all right?
Yes.
100 million.
Yes.
Is that right?
Yes.
Round the throne. And they were saying something.
Jesus.
Is that right?
Yes.
And then he said 10,000 times 10,000.
Uh-huh.
And then hundreds.
Thousands.
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 I can say, Siri, what is 10,000? Let us walk worthy. That's a sight of God. 10,000 times 10,000.
Yes,
and then thousands.
Amen.
Don't be around here sleeping and slide.
That's right.
All right.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Amen.
But fornication.
But fornication.
And all uncleanness.
All uncleanness.
And all covetousness.
Uh-huh.
Let it not be once named among you.
Don't let it once be named among you.
As becometh saints.
Yes, don't let it be once named among you now.
Yes, God.
Is that all right?
Yes.
We got to keep ourselves walking worthy.
Yes.
We can't be, say we holy and walking any kind of way.
That's right. That's right.
I said we can be holy. Is that right? We got to walk a certain way.
Yes.
Young man, young woman, whenever
you
want to touch your
yes,
heart, walk worthy.
That's right.
Don't care. If she do look good, just say, no, I can't fornicate. I can't do that.
That's right.
I can't do that. Because number one, I can't afford a baby. My mom had to buy me my shoes again.
Yes,
and let everybody know the boys know I got a little baby. But if I can't buy no pampers.
Chester,
what do you say? Yeah, need to do that. So you just keep yourself in order until it's legal. And then when you
that's
do it
right.
legal and do it right. And then when you ain't got no pampers, somebody will help.
That's right. That's
somebody
right.
don't mind helping.
Right.
Is that right?
That's right.
Amen.
People
Amen.
Still young. But they ain't want to help you so fast because they know you got that baby at home.
Mm-hmm.
Boy, I ain't committed fornication. Young girl, don't get yourself that title because are you ready for that kind of responsibility? You know, you don't want mama to wake you every day to wash the dishes 12 o'clock. So what if a baby starts waking up and crying and need a bottle?
That's true.
You got to get on up.
Get on up.
Right. And that's my mama. No, it's you. Amen.
Amen.
These are things that you can face. This is some of the stuff. It's just the responsibility of things that we have to consider.
That's right.
You got to be
right.
ready for this responsibility.
Yes. Yes.
Teach it good.
You might be ready for the phone.
Yes.
But if you ain't ready for that phone, you may be having a phone, but you ain't ready for the responsibility.
That's right. That's right.
Yeah. When you do it right, God will bless you.
Yes, He will. Yes, He will.
What are you saying, my beloved?
But fornication and all uncleanness or covetousness, let it not be once named among you as becometh saints.
And what else?
Neither filthiness, nor foolish talking.
Talking all kind of crazy ways.
Nor jesting,
uh-huh.
which are not convenient.
Amen.
But rather, giving of thanks.
But really, you want to give thanks.
Amen.
Is that right?
That's right.
I just want to thank you.
Yes.
We want to thank the Lord. Is that right? All right, go to 16, real brief, my beloved. 16th verse, go ahead.
Redeeming the time.
Redeeming the time.
Because the days are evil.
All right, redeeming the time because we all living in evil days, aren't we?
Yes, we are. Yes,
y'all, we all know that.
Yes, we
are. You got shootings, you got killings. You know, just some of your friends probably got shot and killed or something.
Amen.
On drugs,
amen.
I ain't jail.
Amen.
You know, some of your girlfriends that you... Is that right?
Amen.
You're living in these kind of times.
Yes. See that you walk worthy.
You got to walk worthy of the
Lord. Circumspect.
Not as what?
Fool.
But how?
But why?
Doing what?
Redeeming the time.
Why?
Because the days are evil.
Read the book.
Wherefore, be ye not unwise.
Don't be unwise.
But understanding.
Understanding.
What the will of the Lord is.
Read.
And be not drunk with wine.
Don't be drunk with wine.
Wherein is excess.
Go ahead.
Amen.
But be filled with the Spirit.
Be filled with the Spirit.
Amen.
That's what everybody needs.
Amen.
To be filled with the Spirit.
Amen.
You know how you feel whenever you get filled with food and you was hungry?
Yeah.
You know, if you like seafood or if you like chicken, you know, we was going back to the hotel last night and they just put a Popeyes up there. Made some money last night. We're gonna make some money in the future. Boy, James ain't got a chance. They down by the interstate. But boy, everybody's coming this way, going back. Popeye's got them wrapped. I knew people probably worked last night. Is that right? But they feel, you feel good when you're hungry and have gotten filled. Well, though sometimes when you walk in life, when God fills us with the Holy Ghost, you as a new creature, you feel better.
Yeah.
I mean, you really feel so much better.
Amen.
You don't even think the same way.
Yeah.
You don't even look at things the same way.
No.
You don't in the name of Jesus Christ. Is that right? For the remission of sin.
That's right.
And seek the Lord till you be what?
Filled.
Yes.
Is that all right?
Yes.
Filled with the Holy Ghost. God will fill you.
And
God
will fill you. Ongoing filling, brother.
God will fill you with the Holy
Ghost.
He'll fill you with the Holy Ghost. It's like when you get filled, that's it. Mm-hmm. Ain't no more you can put on it. That's why David said, my cup.
Right.
I got full of that thing. It's running over.
Yeah.
Is that all right? You know how it is when somebody puts something in something and running over.
Right.
You know how it is when we like french fries. I know how it is. And you like it, they put a lot of them in there and it running over. You like when they fall all out the bag and it's still something all that side. And you see I got me some fries today. Well, when you get filled with God, God will make you feel good all over. I mean, this is, am I right, y'all? Both that have experience. Y'all know what I'm talking about. You know it brings about a change in your life.
Yes, sir.
Mickey, just, you know what, Mickey, don't want to hurt nobody.
That's right.
Man might used to be a hunter. He don't even want to go out and kill no coon. He used to knock them coon down. He's kind of particular about the coon. So much love, you don't want to kill a coon. I mean, that's how the Holy Ghost works. Now, it might seem, but it's true. God put so much love and so much humility in your heart. Is that right? That's why children, young people, the Lord want to bless you so that you can be a blessing to your parents. The Lord really want to bless you so that you can. I get emotional because I remember the times my wife and I was struggling. But now we can sit down like a king and a queen.
All right.
And say, hey, all I got to do is tell my daughter. I would like to have this. It won't be long, man.
That's all right.
My wife said, I desire this family. It won't be long until I can sit back.
That's a blessing,
bro. You know, you look at your children as you're raising them. Stuff be tough, stuff be rough. But then when you start raising them, they don't got big. Then they can put a little money in your hand.
All right.
They can cook you a meal and bring you something. Then I can tell my granddaughter, Grandpa, what you want? My grandson, Grandpa, what you want? My grandson, right there, he was out there to the house the other day. He done killed those squirrels. I said, you got to clean him, man. I get him, Grandpa, I get him. So he got it. I can just go out in the woods and walk with him, and he can kill him if I want him. But it's, what I'm saying is, you are. It's a blessing.
Yeah.
Young people, strive to be obedient to your parents.
That's right.
Grandma, granddad, whoever. You know, I know you got these friends sometimes that assassinate parents, but don't you do that.
That's right.
Don't you do that because the scriptures say, honor your father and your mother.
That's right.
That your days may be long.
Maybe, Lord Jesus.
So you cut your own life short.
That's right.
Okay, you're getting a little big now. Man, you get that little mustache, girl, you kind of stick it out and all this kind of stuff that's going on. And
you right,
hormones
you right,
and all this stuff
right,
kicking in.
Right.
And now you want to sassy your mama, your grandma. She can't tell you nothing to do.
Yeah.
God will cut you off.
Yeah.
You still on me. Yes, ma'am. Yes, sir. What you need, grandma? Don't be in such a rush to get out there. Stay around them. Because they can bless you. They can bless you. So don't take the time with them.
Yeah.
Amen. All right, we thank God. Wait.
And be not drunk with wine.
All right.
Wherein is excess.
Yes, sir.
But be filled with the Spirit.
Be filled with the Spirit.
Speaking to yourselves in song.
Yes.
And hymn. And spiritual song. Singing and making a melody in your heart to the Lord.
Yes.
Giving thanks always for all things unto God.
Giving thanks always.
Always. Amen.
Yeah.
Only God can say that.
Giving thanks always.
Always.
And what?
For all things. All of them.
Lord Jesus.
Even when that man cursed you out.
Mm.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you. Thank you for power, God.
Yes, sir.
For all things.
All
things. Yeah, give thanks all week. Amen. Now, sometimes, let me just say this. Sometimes that stuff gets hard. Sometimes you go mannerize and go motorize. Somebody trying to do it a certain way. You may not want to give thanks right then. You might start rubbing your hand together.
Yes, sir.
But God.
Huh?
But God.
You got to give him praise.
Yes, sir.
Because you know why? Because we're all still human.
Yeah.
And that's why the scripture said, walk in the spirit.
Right.
You want to fulfill the lust of the flesh. But the spirit, right, wars against the flesh,
right.
And the flesh against the spirit.
See God going on. Amen.
All right.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
By the wayside.
Okay.
Amen. Truly, truly, truly.
Yes.
Amen. It is a blessing. Amen. Yeah, you sit and eat and feast off the truth.
Amen. Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
Truth. Uh-huh. And the truth will make you.
Thank you.
Amen. So we thank God anytime. Amen. Amen. To hear the truth.
Yeah.
Amen. So we thank God for the word of God. Amen. Coming unto us. Amen. And blessing our soul.
Yes.
Amen. I just was sitting back listening. He caught me up. I tell him sometimes you can listen and somebody will say something. Mm-hmm. And you gotta keep them going into another world.
Right.
Because you gotta because they still talking.
Right.
And you don't want to miss the rest of them.
Yeah, right.
You know, he stopped talking about thousands and thousands.
Thousands upon thousands.
And I was caught up in that milk.
I was in the loop.
Yeah. I got to let you know, Bridget, I was in the loop.
Yeah.
And I don't know how I got around the throne, but I got there. Ain't good.
Yes. Hallelujah. Yes.
God is good.
Hallelujah.
God is good.
Yes.
Worthy.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
Yes. Oh, hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Worthy.
Hallelujah. I don't know. See, because I wouldn't take a chance today.
Hallelujah.
I wouldn't take a chance of not being in one of them numbers.
That's right.
Yes. Thank you, Lord.
I got to be.
Got to be.
I don't know about nobody. I got to be in one of those numbers.
Yes. Thank you, Lord.
To get the opportunity to stand around the throne and worship God Almighty.
Yes.
We have to have somebody. We haven't given their life to Christ. Look here. Give their life to Christ.
Thank you, Lord.
Want to be a part of that.
Thank you, Jesus.
See, you know what about you. I done came to the conclusion that people know where they're not.
That's right.
Look, you can call them what you want to call them and say what you want to say to them, but they know when they're not in the opposite. I have to ask somebody before we leave here today.
Thank
we done
Lord.
Spent some hours here. And it don't make good sense to spend all this time here and then leave out the same way you came in. It don't make good sense to be here all this time and hear this precious word of God.
Yeah.
And see the anointing of God and then walk back out the same way.
Talk y'all talk.
It don't make sense.
No.
And me and my wife be talking sometimes. And we be talking about what needs to be done here and need to be there. And then we'll fall back on the old saying that we got. Mm-hmm. I'll tell her, she'll tell me, what we got to do is eliminate the excuses.
All the excuses.
That's what we have to do. She's Robert. Don't worry about it. Eliminate all the excuses.
That's right. Jesus did.
And then truth has to come out.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
So I'm finna eliminate all the excuses.
Because
somebody might say, if they had to open up the doors for the church, I would have walked out. Now Peter opened the door for the church on the building. And it ain't never been closed. But you know how it is sometimes. I had a fella told me, I said, well, you ain't never came by the house. You know what he said? He said, you ain't never invited me.
That's right.
Here's your invitation to Christ.
All right.
While you got a chance.
All right.
While the blood still yet running warm in your veins.
Yeah.
Perhaps, amen, here is the opportunity. We standing on the way.
Thank you, God.
I mean, the people did a fantastic, wonderful job. And so we have to eliminate the excuses, amen, for everybody else. So if you leave here today in the same condition that you came in, and God should call you home, one of the things you can't say, is that I didn't have
a change.
So here's your opportunity, because we want to give you the chance today.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. To give your life up to Christ. Amen. Just make an intelligent decision.
Yes, Jesus.
That's the decision I made. And I have learned a lot since I was 15 years old.
Yes,
but the best decision that I made it at the age of 50. I came to Christ.
That's all right.
Best decision I made in my whole life.
Yeah.
I heard a preacher say he was about 18. Master said he be big. What am I saying? You ain't got to be old like me now. Understand the lingo, some bruises. Make them? Yeah. One of my friends, one of the young ladies that I work with, sent me a text and say, "Mr. Reynolds, I'm gonna be OOO tomorrow." Said, yeah, she gonna, I'll be out of the office.
That's right. That's it.
And I was saying, she gonna be OOO. Right? And I had to go down the hallway and find another young person and say, "What is she telling me?" And she say, "Oh, she telling you she gonna be out of the office today. She just reminding you." I said, "Oh, well, thank you, cause I'd be walking down the hall looking for her." But sometimes when she don't understand, she can reach out to y'all.
Amen. Right.
And then y'all can talk a language with her. And y'all can talk about the struggles that y'all been through. And y'all can encourage her to go home.
Yes.
And y'all can tell her whatever happened, don't quit.
Amen.
No matter what the other ones say around you, don't quit.
Right.
Hang on in there. And you're going to be all right.
Yes, Lord.
And come on, y'all, just reach out. You can make connections right here.
Make a connection.
Hallelujah.
Jesus,
yes,
give it to us.
In the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, we call that.
Thank you,
God. Oh God, touch your heart, God.
Hallelujah, God.
Touch your mind, God. Oh God, bless the decision making today, God, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, as she goes forth today, God, give her the strength that she needs, God. Oh God, clean her up right now, God, in the name of Jesus, God. Touch her right now, God, from the crown of her head, Lord, to the sole of her feet, God. You made her, God. Oh God, and you know all about her, God. You know her going in and coming out, God. Oh God, so we ask you, God, to let your Holy Ghost put flame upon her, God. In the name of Jesus, God, save her this day, God. In the name of Jesus, God.
Thank you,
Lord.
Thank you,
God. Oh God, she's healed, God.
Yes, Lord.
Oh God, from every manner of sin, from every manner of sickness. Oh God, deliver her this day, God.
Yes, Lord.
Oh God, we thank you, God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh God, oh God, oh God.
Thank you.
Oh God, allow her to be able to go forth in your name, God. Oh God, and take her, God. According to your mighty will, God. Have mercy on her, God. Oh God, let your Holy Ghost fill her right now.
Yes, Jesus.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
In your name, God. Thank you, Lord.
God, bless her. From the crown of her head, Lord, to the sole of her feet, God. Oh God, we know you're able. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Talk with her, get a phone number. Get a phone number, talk with her, get a phone number. All of y'all, I expect when I ask about her, I expect somebody to be able to tell me. All right? All right. Thank God for everybody. Let's give the Lord a big hand clap. offering. We thank God for you. We thank God for what it is. And while we are doing the speaker's offering, we're going to give you a few announcements. Amen. Amen. We're going to give a few announcements. Amen. Our next general meeting, amen, will be in Hampton, Georgia. Amen. The fifth Sunday meeting.
Thank you.
Amen. It'll be our next general meeting. It'll be the fifth Sunday meeting. That's this month in Hampton, Georgia. Amen. And we're looking to have a glorious time in the Lord. Amen. We're looking, amen, on that Saturday. Amen. Saturday before the fifth Sunday. And then we're looking to have, amen, a cookout. Amen. At the park. Amen. Starting at 11 o'clock. We asking everybody, amen, that can and will, amen, come out and enjoy, amen, some good, wholesome fun with us. Amen. Outside, we're going to laugh. We're going to talk. We'll get to know each other a little bit more. Amen. We're going to eat some hamburgers and hot dogs and some potato salad. And bring your fishing rod. Amen. Get some life, some license on the house. Amen. You can fish out there. Amen. You can play in the park. Amen. We're looking to have a nice time. Amen. On that Saturday. Amen. And on that Sunday, amen, we have our fifth Sunday meeting. Amen. The theme for this fifth Sunday, amen, is God is limitless. Y'all got to know the God we serve. God is limitless. We also, amen, Deacon Reynolds been out and got a vendor. Amen. He has some t-shirts made. Amen. The price of the t-shirts is $15 if you want a God is limitless t-shirt. Amen. It's a real nice t-shirt. Amen. God is limitless. Amen. $15. And we ask you to get with Deacon Reynolds. Amen. Amen. We take orders for him. And for some strange reason, the guy won't print the t-shirts without money. Some strangers. We thank God. If you, amen, you desire a t-shirt, amen, we got that much trust in you, amen, that you'll bring your $15 if you call us and you don't have it right now, but you desire a t-shirt, and you're going to come. And I say that again. And you're going to come. Then we'll be willing to front your t-shirt for you. But if you don't go, we might have let my wife think about the charge of every $5. That all right?
That's all right.
We thank God for it. Thank God for the price. And thank God, amen, good that thank you for reminding me. Amen, on next, amen, Saturday, Christ Anointed is at Bishop Irvin, amen, and God's worship is in Atlanta. And then that Sunday, amen, our senior pastor will be preaching, amen, at God's worship. So next weekend, we'll be at God's worship on Saturday and Sunday. Amen. Saturday night, amen, Christ Anointed is on, and then Sunday, amen, Brian Tiffany. Amen. And we're looking to have a glorious time, and we act as many as can, amen, come be with us in both services, amen, because we're not going to let our pastor come up that far and not be with him.
Amen.
Amen. So we close it up that way. Amen. Christ anointed on that Sunday just to be with pastor on that, with that Sunday. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So we thank God for him. Amen. Amen. Anything else? We want to miss something else. Sisters, anything?
Amen.
Amen.
We give thanks and praises to everyone that came out, especially our speaker. And we thank God for you. We're so glad that you were able to accept. Because Lord has been good to you. And I know you was down, but God has brought you all back up. Amen. Thank God for your wonderful companion. And we have a little special token of appreciation that we want to give to a mother. Hold on for a second. I'll go get it. Thank you. Bryant Temple and all of our sisters here, we wanted to present this little token of appreciation to you. We love you, and we love your family. God bless you. Thank you. Donation to a financial donation, and we thank God for everything. We pray for your success, traveling mercy, and we ask you to join us in the back for our little repast.
God bless you.
All right. Amen. So we thank God again for everybody. Thank God, amen. Amen. We thank God, amen. Like we said earlier, the pastor, amen, started three times. I went out and called him to see what he said. He said he started here three times. And every time he started, he got a flat tire. And finally ended up having to tow the car back home. Amen. So he was trying to make it. I did this there. I asked him that he wanted to send him some help.
He's on his way.
He's on his way. That's them rich folks, they got more than one car. We thank God for him, and hopefully even before y'all leave, you get the opportunity of making it. Amen. Before you leave, so y'all can leave some of the scene. Okay. Amen. Before we leave out. Amen. So we just thank God for everybody. Thank God for all of our preachers. Got another one.
Yes. I just want to say thank you all again. Thanks to God so much for having us. I really love coming up here and pray that the Lord continue to bless my husband, my pastor, Ella Butler, and our family, and all the saints of God back in Tallahassee. But I do want to say, today, thank you, praise the Lord, for my grandchildren. I have three grandchildren that received the Holy Ghost, been baptized.
All right. Her
name is Brianna.
Yes. All right.
All right. We call her Butterfly, but today is her birthday. She turned 10.
All right.
The Lord be all over this young lady. I celebrate my 60th birthday in March, and my kids gave a celebration. We went out eating last Saturday. After that, we went up to the temple to praise the Lord and just have a good time there. Lord was just all over her also. And her birthday, Kayla, birthday was on Friday, and she received the Holy Ghost too. She's 10 years old.
Yeah. got to wait. I used to think that one time. When I got old, I'm going to get saved when I get about 50 or 60. Then I done all I wanted to do, and then I'm going to get saved. But the best thing that you can do is give Christ your life now. It makes so much of a difference in your life. It removes so many worries and so many pains. I tell folks all the time, it was easy for me to quit smoking. Because I ain't never started. It was easy for me to quit drinking. Because I didn't never start. It was easy for me to stay away from drugs, because I ain't never started. And since I ain't never started none of that, it was easy for me to stay away from it.
That's so true.
That's the way God is. All you got to do is give God the praise and give God. Now is the acceptable time to serve God. We going to get out of here. I'm telling you, I feel another praise coming up. You show me. All right, because that might be another reason for the praise.
Somebody asked me
to like pass
up to somebody. I was
sitting
there
working
yesterday.
Okay.
And I
visited
since I
got here.
Come on,
y'all sisters. Come on, help out.
She was behind
the piano
most of the day.
Yes, yes.
Some of the sisters
didn't
come from out of town.
Our sisters who didn't make it yesterday, go ahead and raise your hand. So we thank God for you. Amen. Isn't it beautiful, amen, to be with a fellowship together? I get excited when we start talking about church and my fellowship. And guess what, y'all? We still got 30 minutes before the Titanic go off. Anybody seen the movie Titanic? If y'all seen the movie Five Times, that movie was like 4 hours and some change. Yeah. So we still got some more Titanic time to go. I'm just saying. But I know y'all ready. And we thank God for them. Y'all ain't jumping. Thank everybody ain't no jumping.
Amen. We thank God for each and every one of you. We thank God for what our eyes have seen, our ears have heard. We thank God for the young sister that have decided that she wanted to do what is right according to the will of God. May God will continue to bless you. Because He's able to. Without a shadow of doubt. Don't be discouraged. We thank God for that. We thank God for all of the other young people and pray that God will ever continue to bless you because He's able in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. So we're certainly grateful for all things. I just want to say thank you, all the saints, those of you that are here, those that have prayed for us and prayed for me when I was ill. We just thank God for that. Thank God for your tokens of love in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And we just say happy belated birthday to Sister Vicky in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And we just say happy birthday to Elder Brian. I think his is 13.
13.
Yeah, and then mine's coming around the 12th. Oh, so we need to pray together. We thank God for that, and may God ever continue to bless all of you. That said, I thank God for all my children that are here. We thank God for all of them. So stay encouraged. May the Lord ever continue to richly bless you. We thank God for the choir that was able to sing today to the glory of God. We just thank God for the instrument players and all of you that are here. And continue to pray that God will bless us and give us a safe trip back to our destination.
Yes,
we just say
yes,
thank you, and we thank God for you. May God ever continue to bless all of you and continue to strive. We look forward to the Lord blessing us on the next time, whenever we see it's His will for us to be able to come together again on this side. So that being all, let us sing. Let's look to the Lord, not unto him that is able to keep you from falling into any fall. Before the presence of his glory and exceeding joy, unto the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forever, world without end. Let us all say together, amen. Amen. God bless all of you.
Amen. Amen.